Hello everybody, I'm Michael Wood and welcome to the Webmaster Academy. Today I'm going to be talking about the Save the Date template from Wix.com. And this template is really great for any type of special event where you want people to RSVP. So it's not just for weddings, you can use it for anniversaries or engagement parties or anything else that you want to celebrate. This is a quick website template you can use to get people to easily RSVP to your event electronically. Now, there are different services out there that do this sort of thing, and they're dedicated to that. That's fine, but again, this class is about web design, so you're going to learn not only the functionality, but you'll learn the web design that goes behind it. And that's the advantage of using a web design program to create your RSVP. If you use a third party, you're going to pay them a lot of money and you won't really learn anything along the way. So let's go ahead and get started with the Save the Date template from Wix.com. So once again, I'm Michael Wood, and this is the Save the Date RSVP template from Wix.com. You don't have to use Wix to understand the design principles that are being applied here. All right, so let's first take a tour of the website itself. And then at the end of the video, I'll show you how to customize the site to match your own theme or event. Let's go into the site itself now. And what I'll do is I'll do a quick refresh because this is the best way to see any kind of animations that might be happening. So you see the title is animated. It says Emily and Daniel Save the Date. At the top left-hand corner, we have the home button and the RSVP button. Just two buttons, very simple. I'm going to scroll down and you can see the little animations and the fun cartoons that are here. By the way, you can use all of these cartoons and animations as part of your template. It comes with the template itself. Here we have the couple dancing. So it's very fun. A little bit of a retro feel to it. So that's a pretty simple site. It just says, hey, follow us, check out the date, and don't forget to bring your dancing shoes, and this site will allow them to RSVP. If you click on RSVP, that then takes you to this button here, RSVP button. And now we're going to use Wix events to get the job done. So they will simply fill out their first name, last name, email, hit submit. And here's the best part, they will get email confirmations and reminders about the event. They will even be able to cancel if they need to electronically. So a lot of these things will be handled on the back end, and you as that final user will be able to get a list of all of your RSVP participants, and you can then continue to send them shout outs and other types of emails, but you will have control of that list. And you know, it's happening all in the background, and this is really web design at its best, its simplest, and its finest, because a great website allows you to do the things you love to do without babysitting the code and the website itself. Let the website work hard for you, and that's what this template does. It'll collect those names and let the guests know about the information. So once you build your website, you would go ahead and get that link and then share that link across all of your social medias or whatever campaigns that you want to launch. And that link will give them the information and the ability to RSVP. So it's very simple to set up. Let's talk about how to customize the site for yourself. Before I go under the hood and uncover what's behind this website. I just want to see if there's any questions or comments. And if you're watching this and during the replay, then go ahead and send me a question, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. All right, let's go ahead and edit the site now. So I'm now going into the Wix editor. And as you can see, it's using this vector art, and I'm going to move it around. See this? So I can move this, and you could just easily swap it out. If you don't like this design, then press delete on your keyboard. Boom, it's gone, right? Now you could then go ahead and add an image, and you could upload your own custom image, which is even better if you have a picture maybe of a couple who's engaged and they're getting ready for the wedding. They can go ahead and load their photo here, or you can feel free to use any of the free Wix images, just depending on the type of event that you're having. I'm just looking through some of their stock images, seeing if I could find anything. So here's a good one. This would be good for like a 30th anniversary party. So you have the people holding the 30 right there. And all you would need to do is position this graphic onto the page. And if you want to give it a little bit more depth, you can make it go behind the title. So you do that by clicking on the image. And then what we're going to do is change the order. So when I click the image, you'll see over here on the right, there's this sort of this hanging menu. I'm just clicking and dragging it around so you can notice it. You may not have seen it. And over here we have different controls, and one of them is the arrangement button, and we're going to send this to the back. And all that does is pop the image right behind the text, and then that gives you that 3D effect. Let's go ahead and preview. So see, we've quickly changed the event. And we can just change the text to 30th anniversary. And you could change, of course, the font colors and, you know, the font, whatever you want to do, just by selecting the text. Click on Edit Text and then change the colors to whatever matches your mood or style. Okay, so that's how you customize the text and the graphics. You would then change the date, of course. Unless yours is on November 23rd, 2023, then, well, I guess you can leave it there. All right, and then the Join Us, again, you could switch out these graphics. These are just vector graphics. And what's nice about vector graphics, as you can see, it's got transparency. So when I move this guy around, you could see the information is all right there. And it doesn't cover up the information like a normal photo would. So if you want to switch this out with vector art, then you could upload your own, get some from Deposit Photos or any other stock images site, or you can click Add, and you're going to go to click on vector art. And so these are vectors that were created, and you could go ahead and scroll through. These are all the featured items, they have icons, and then you could click on more if you like more of that category. So here's different characters right here. So if, let's say, we just click and drag this mermaid right here. So she's a vector art. As you can see, she maintains that transparency. And you can go ahead and resize the image. I don't know, you know, what kind of anniversary party this is. It's looking kind of interesting here. You can use this rotate tool to give it some character there. And then you could animate too. So if I click on the vector art, click on this animation button, and I'm going to say when she comes in, I want her to kind of float in very slowly. Let's see what that looks like. I'm going to hit preview. Okay, save the date. And as you could see, she just kind of floats in right there. Go ahead and update the address and the date there. And then for follow us, you can go ahead and put the link to your Instagram account if you're going to have one, or just a hashtag is fine. And that's pretty much how to customize it. This is a shape. We can change this shape to, let's say, a circle. And you see the text is still there, and all we did is change that shape. And the shape moves by itself, as you can see. I'm just placing it behind the text right there. We could change that shape and switch out the graphics. Or you could even just put a whole photo here if you want. Now, this is interesting because it's actually a slideshow. So let's do a preview. I'm going to Control Z and undo my delete. Let's look at the preview. So if you look at here, it's actually a little bit of a slideshow. And it's just two slides, but it gives that whole fun, whimsical feel to it. And you could just change that by clicking on the slideshow itself, and you could change each slide individually by clicking on the slide selector and then selecting and changing the art. So, and it was set to autopilot. So if I click on settings, you want to make sure it says auto plays on loading, and that gives you that just that back and forth kind of feel to it. So that's how you change the slideshow down at the bottom. Or you could just have a slideshow, especially if you're celebrating something like 30th anniversary event. Show some photos, like maybe from the very first anniversary or any years in between, just showing the progression. And now here we are at 30 years. That'd be a good idea for a slideshow. So this is actually an embedded slideshow that's already ready for you to just change and swap out the images. Now the background is this interesting white and pink sort of design here. And what we could do is we want to change that, let's say to bananas for some reason here. So as you could see, the entire backdrop of this website is bananas. I know it looks really crazy, but hey, it's a 30th anniversary party. That looks pretty fun to me, especially if you're gonna have a tropical theme right there. But that's how you change the background. Just click on the background, change background. You can select just a solid color, or you can select an image. In this case, they had selected basically a pattern. But you can find something that's going to fit. You could even do a video if you think that's going to work out better. So here's a video background. Let's see what that looks like. See the record spinning? Now, does that look like fun or what? They're gonna have a great time at this party. And as you could see, the video plays in the background, and the website is just kind of layered just perfectly right over it. In fact, I don't know about you. I think I like the video background better than the original background. So that's where you can really have a lot of fun in your customizations. Now let's talk about the Wix events. So this is the engine behind that RSVP button. So I click on the button. I'm going to manage the event. This will load up the Wix dashboard that allows you to add multiple events. In this case, it's only one event, and I can actually do a lot of options here. Of course, you give it a name, and you can give it an image if you'd like, a little description. You can adjust the date and time. You can adjust the time zone. Your location could be to be determined, and you would just turn that selector on, or you can go ahead and give the address. And then this is where you want to list all the details about the event, things that will be provided, things guests should be aware of, maybe important speakers, things like that. You would put that information there. Maybe you have a booklet or instructions for your event, like maybe it's a camp. Then you'll want to click on the link button and upload maybe your camp, camper's guide or something like that. Now, for tickets, in this case, it's a free event. But you can go ahead and start doing tickets. So I have to type something in here before it lets me go to the next step. All Let me see. At the minimum, I had to put a title. I'll just say it's to be determined. Let's see if it lets me go to tickets. Oh, not yet? Okay, some things are optional. So we need to add a beautiful image. You can upload your own, or you could use one of the ones from Wix here. Now I'm just going to upload a quick image. That's optional. Location is to be determined. Let's see if it lets me go now. Let's go ahead and create the event. Now let's edit it. Okay, now we can go to tickets. So for tickets, I can do this for free. It's okay to offer free tickets. It's a good way of tracking who's going and who's not without them needing to pay. It's also a good way to collect their contact information. But here we could say it's for free, or we could say it's for sale, and that you can call the ticket a name, like VIP or balcony or early bird, whatever you want to call it. You can limit the quantity, which I highly suggest. If you're holding these particular venues and you don't want 1,000 people showing up to your 80-person, you know, ballroom, you can adjust the price and the currency and a description. You would then save this. And when you save it, they will not only be able to RSVP, but they can actually pay for a ticket. This is good for any kind of event registration. Now, the idea of this website was just to do a quick announcement. This would be good if you just have a one event that you're trying to sell or give tickets for or have some kind of registration. This website template works really good for that as well. All right, let me just see if there's any questions out there. Everything looks good. All right. So that is the wedding RSVP save the date template from Wix.com. If you enjoyed this video, give me a like, a heart, tell me what you think about it. I'd love to get people's feedback. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel and check us out at the Webmaster Academy. That's www.webmasteracademy.online. And I will actually show you from concept to automation how to build your own website without writing code. We offer a low price membership. I add new content every week. We have a great community of learners there. Check us out at the Webmaster Academy if you want to know more about how to be an incredible web designer and webmaster. Hey, make sites for yourself or for others and make some money while you're at it. Anyway, thanks for joining me here, and remember to save the date. Have great fun with this template, and we'll see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye. Save the date. Have great fun with this template, and we'll see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye. Save the date. Have great fun with this template.